Iron leg and iron gloves. There you go. Bish bash bosh. Oh, look at that shitty ass bandana. Oh, that is pure ghetto. That is terrible, mate. What's that, Simpson? The only thing you didn't have, what was that? No, Simpson! You cheeky sod. Yeah, so the steel arrows, flaming arrows, splints, but something else missing, isn't there? How many splints have we got? Oh my god, we're down to 20 splints. That's shocking. We had like, so I think we have like a stack of like 60 splints at some point. I give the fuck up. I give up so badly. Flaming arrows. Right, so I need. Let's just make 20, wasn't it? So I need a couple of cloth fragments and 40 gunpowder. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'd say it's good to know, though, right? Even with a really bad death, I suppose we can get back on our feet relatively quickly. I'm amazed at how low I am on some things, like cloth. You think of the amount of scavenging we did early on in the game, and we literally just like stockpiled it all, and we've just been living on that ever since, haven't we? I don't think I can repair these. Oh, whoa, what the fuck? Oh, that's not good. What happened there? Oh, yeah, that's not good. Cloth fragment. Should I use the last of my cloth to repair them? Repair. Okay. Come back to that. So the only thing I'm actually missing is my pullover, to be honest. Oh, nice purple pants, look. And I want my Uggs back, man. This is shit. Where would you be Uggs, dude? Three cloth fragments. This is a game changer, guys. This is a game changer. I've actually got some really nice axes in there, so we will come back at some point and play about with them. Because look, I've actually got a much better. But what I'm not going to risk it. We've got to go back. We might have a bit of a fight on our hands. What is missing? Can anyone think what's missing on here? Strike! You've just done it. I just saw you type it out, mate. Anti-bloody biotics, thank you, sir. And thank you, Simpsy, as well. You've just given me a screenshot. Wow. That should be all right for us to get back. We've got arrows, we've got flaming arrows, admittedly not a lot of them. We've got everything we need. Should we go back? Anyone think of anything we need to do before we head back? I'm not taking the auger, I'm not taking the nail gun. You can fuck right the fuck off. I now have an element of self-doubt within within myself that shit can go down. I tell you what, the foot piss should come and watch this and realise just how fast a fully maxed out character can just get wrecked. Oh, that ladder's freaked out. It's a re honestly though, the one thing I am quite gutted about, because you know it is a laugh and it's nice to sort of have shit go wrong in a way, but I am really, really devastated that I lost my shotgun. I've had that shotgun for so long. Jezebel, how I will lit mourn that shotgun. I will have a small cry later tonight. I shit thee not. Let's take 500 wood. Let's always Simpsy's golden rule. Frames, 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 frames. A nice stack of 30 frames. Never leave home without them. Right, we're well fed. Super well fed, apparently. Don't actually need any. I'm going to actually have a glass of goldenrod tea to celebrate. I might even have a coffee later. In fact, I will have a coffee. No, because it's negative. No, it's negative. Wellness, isn't it? Right, I need to keep these above 70%. to get my wellness back, guys. So please don't let me forget. Now, the mini bike should be all sorted. Yeah, I think that's a really good idea, actually, Fortune. I think that's a really, really, really good idea. I'm almost tempted to go and do that before we leave tomorrow, you know. Because the cloth is really useful, isn't it? What about we go in? There's a load of cotton just outside the western side of Caliper City. Shall we go and pluck it and plant it? Because I have no... I mean, I have like one or two cotton upstairs. Is there anything anybody can think of that we need to do? Or we're ready to go, aren't we? Thank you for the follow, Lison. No, don't worry, Fortune. No, I've had enough for trying to keep the pace going for the stream. I've learned a lesson there, mate. Just because we're streaming don't mean we should be pushing it. I suppose we might as well put this back. We'll drop that off before we leave, all right? Let's go and throw this back upstairs. We've got a bit of time to kill. Don't worry, Mark. I'll show you the pyramid before we set off. I'll show you the pyramid because I know a few people have asked. The Grum Pyramid. Also go and plant some cotton in the farm before we leave. Oh, wrong chest. So that can go in there, that can go in there. I found a use for the rotting flesh. You are going to love it when I put this mod in. You are going to shit bricks when I show you this one. I'm not even going to talk about it. Mark my words. Remember the day, the 4th of July, when I said you will shit bricks. There will be clapping and screaming when I show you the mod I've got planned for rotting flesh. Plenty of shotgun shells. Actually, you know what we should do? Let's just have a quick look. The only reason this isn't 600 is the shotgun. I suppose it's the long barrel, isn't it? I've got a 577. That's a hunting rifle barrel. Shotgun short. They're all hunting rifle, aren't they? I don't think I've got a better one, to be honest. It's a shame in a way. I mean, I could repair it. I'm not sure what would happen and what sort of difference it's going to make. Should we just do it anyway? Doesn't hurt, does it? Hunting rifle. So the smallest or the weakest component in that is the receiver. I haven't actually got very many hunting rifle receivers. I remember when I found that perfect 600 hunting rifle, I was just like over the moon. I've never actually rock and rolled with this thing. Now, someone actually mentioned the other type of shotgun shell, didn't they? The slugs. So used with long shotguns to do more damage can be crafted after reading the schematic. See, these take casings and bullet tips, whereas these just take paper and buckshot. Maybe we can upgrade to those in a little bit. Can I actually use these? Oh God, I didn't even think about that. Oh yeah, you can. That's all right. Nice. It's a slight upgrade, actually. We've never had... We never put a torch on the hunting rifle. Just suddenly realised before. Good Lord, boys and girls. Good Lord. Right, I suppose let's do some spins now. I did say today we were going to do the big golden Grumbomb one, didn't we? Just have a bloody coffee. I think that's the last thing I need is a coffee. let's do a couple of normal spins, then we'll do the June winner. So I'm sorry, but the three people, that's Spectrum, Mario, and Advina, you all died. Sorry, guys. It doesn't happen often, but what's clay for? You basically smelt the clay down in the forge with the iron, and then you can make things like the rebar, as an example. So clay's very useful, mate. You essentially need to mix it with the raw iron to make forged iron and steel. Thank you very much for the follow, Sasha. Really appreciate that. So next up is Triggers as an actual survivor. There's our level one wheel. Ladies, are you okay to do this? Oh, what's going on? Well, that cock blocked me then, that did. Oh, golly gosh. Well, I tell you what, I'd already called the name, so we'll do Triggers and then we'll do Fortune. So first up is Triggers, yeah? Good luck, mate. What a morning. Good Lord. $75 GBs. Right, this next one's for Fortune for her epic poem even in the Discord channel. Dizzy. Good luck, Fortune. I'm so dizzy, my head is spinning like a whirlpool, it never ends. And it's you, girl, making it spin. It's another 75. Next up is Sky. Good luck, Sky. Excuse me. Oh, well, that's going to be interesting. So, Sky, you've just got VIP bronze. So that's going to run through to the 4th of August. So congratulations. I'll do one more out of the hat. That's Chicken Momo. Good luck, Chica.
That is one big pile of shit.
Right, now to do the big June draw. Okay, so this is everyone that won a... Let's have a look. That is the Grumbomb winner selector. What I've done, Fortune, you actually... I think you had like three, but you also had the highest June bid. So I've just like merged it all into one segment for you. So those are the winners of the June Golden Grumbombs. So we're going to do a spin now. If I can remember how the hell we do that. Are you all ready? Are you all ready? Is everyone happy? And honestly, a massive thank you to everyone that's been supporting the channel over the last month. It's been absolutely amazing. So many donations, just so many cool new faces, as well as all the old faces sticking around. So we've had loads and loads of GGB winners. So our little way of saying thank you to everyone that's played a part in all the mini games. Here we go. This is for June. Interesting, this one, wasn't it? Yeah. Oh! Oh! It's the Rooney! Is it? Yeah, there we go. It's Rooney. Congratulations, Rooney. I know you're not having the best time of it right now, mate. So, congratulations. Congratulations, mate. Shat It, Simpson. You love that bloody song. She has it on repeat on a Sony Walkman on cassette, don't you? Right, Grumbum Prize Selector. I can't remember whether this is a 15-second spin or not. I'll just do a normal spin music. Good luck, Rooney. I think this is a 30-second spin, actually. Yeah, it is. I'm gonna play that. I'm gonna change your theme tune to that now, Simpsy. How'd you like that? How'd you like them beans, girl? God, keep going, keep going. Oh, he's gonna be 20. Could be 20. Could be 20. Could be 20. Go on, keep going, keep going, keep going. Yeah, he's got 20 quid. 20 quid. Fuck! I ain't got 20 quid. Congratulations, mate. You've just won 20 quid's worth of Steam games, or however you want to play that. So there you go, folks. You saw it here. Bish, bash, bosh. Right, I need to go round the back of Rackham's tonight. Congratulations, Rooney. And honestly, seriously, thank you so much to everyone that's been supporting the channel. It's just been a phenomenal month. It really has. There's been so many laughs my end. I've just lost count, honestly. It's been an absolute bloody riot. It really has. So, Okay, so are we okay to go? We're going to go. I'll tell you what, we'll go and show you the Grum Pyramid. I know a couple of you wanted to have a look at that. And we'll go and plant the. Well, I'll tell you what we'll do is we'll park the bike over here. Oh shit, we got Z's coming in, really? Oh my god! Actually, I was just for a brief moment wondering where my. Oh Jesus. It's 4 o'clock, right? What? Oh, it sounds so different, doesn't it? Wow, that's quite interesting, actually. I quite like this. Oh, I do like the long-barreled shotgun, guys. Oh, it's got like I don't know. It just feels like it's got a bit more oomph to it, doesn't it? That's shockingly different. I'm quite impressed with that. Right, let's get some cotton. So how do I do this then, Fortune? Is it just a case of breaking it down into cotton seeds, like a normal flour as such? Let's recipes cotton seed. Yeah, there you go. Bish bash bosh. Let's get these and let's get them planted up, and then we can hopefully start. Resolving our extremely serious. Hang on. So if you go to that, recipes, cloth fragment, 2 cotton for 1 cloth fragment. It's not too bad, is it? We can plant, what, 91 of these, I suppose. If we did like a couple of cycles of 91, it should sort of keep us in cloth for things like the duct tape, which we need for the exploding crossbow bolts and what have you. Oh, does it end today, does it? I wonder if we can get in touch with him. It's not even yet, is it, Fortune? I should have said, mate, and then we could have done it. I'd have done it yesterday. I'd have just like taken 20 minutes out and done the wheel. Oh, that sucks, mate. I didn't realise. Yeah, I think once we've got everything back in, you know, in order as such, Fortune, I think that's a really good idea. Actually come and start doing the farming proper, because of course I've got the tomato seeds now as well, mate, if they're still there when we get back. So this is the Grum Pyramid, for those of you that were asking. Like I said, I know Snipe's done a little bit of work, haven't you, on Discord to show us what we need to do next. So that's it there, look. Nice and hollowed out. We're hoping to keep it hollowed out all the way up. I tell you what, I've had a lot of fun doing this. I really have, and I'm super, super excited to come back and finish it off. It's sort of why we've decided to go and set up this concrete production facility over in the desert. One, just to sort of get away from Caliper City for a bit, because it's always nice to come home and, you know, do something a little bit different. I've actually got 23 cotton here. I'm not convinced we didn't actually start doing this at some point. So that's actually 55 cotton. I do need to go back. Please remind me to go and put some of this stuff away. Now, should we get rid of the corn? I think you can actually plant it in between, but I really can't be arsed trying to figure that out. I'm sure you can plant the cotton in the middle. It's about time we harvested the corn anyway. We should really have been doing this, because then we could have like dropped it off to other people on the server. I can't wait for my tomatoes. Oh, they're gonna be gorgeous. Me tammy tomatoes, mate. You're gonna love them. Ends at 6 o'clock tonight, does it? We'll all have to spam Rooney with his with his winnings. Mind you, I've got to go out in a bit, so even if he got in touch at the end of the stream, I'm not sure I could do it in time. What I'll do, Fortunes, is link some of the mods I'm looking at, because I know you like the sort of farming side of things, don't you? You're a big 7 Days to Die fan at the minute. You'll have to let me know what you think. Have you picked anything up, Simpsy? I know you said you hadn't yesterday. You're not been tempted by any little cheeky games? Well, they look really nice, don't they? Oh, they look alive! Can't believe we've got this beautiful farm, and I just literally built it and left it. I mean, honestly, that same crop of potatoes over there and corn has probably been here for nigh on 6 months. I shit you not, in-game time. I don't think that's even an exaggeration, is it? The fuck is that noise? What the fuck was that? Did you just hear that? It sounded like some hideous, like, alien slug or something. That can't have just been me. I've never heard that noise ever. We're about to be invaded. Yeah, so it'll be nice to come back and pick all these up, get the old cloth back up and running. It's a good sized farm, isn't it? I like the thought of sort of like a bit of crop rotation. Should really do it more regularly. It doesn't take long either, does it? Not now I've got it all like. This is why I want it done like properly and not just some like half-assed effort. If I got the tomatoes, I'd chop some of these down. But anyway, that's it. We've done. The cotton is planted. Well, hopefully we'll solve our cotton issues. We'll throw the corn in there. We've got a ridiculous amount of that there. Potatoes can go over that. Yucca I can't plant yet until we mod it in. Alright, so. Shit, no, hang on. Garden hoe. The Sammies can go downstairs, as can the beer. Lock that up. Let's do this. We're nearly ready to go home. Well, I say home, back to the desert, aren't we? No, you must have heard that. It was like a... It's not that. It was horrible. I don't believe that none of you heard that. If you didn't hear it, it means it's in my house. So tell me you fucking heard it. I've run out. Seen a win. That was it. I ran out, mate. I've got none left, so. Repair kits and all that jazz we'll sort out when we get home. That can go in the hammy shammy cupboard that Fortune loves so much. Beer, I think, goes in the first aid kit. Let's see what we'll put that down there. That's it. We're ready to go, guys. Let's head back to the desert. And this time, let's not die. Let's not die at all. Yeah, I knew I heard something. Oh, God damn it. Right, let's go and put the pine cones away. Let's eat some food, and then we're off. It did. It sounded like flippy floppy. Like I said, it reminded me of some sort of alien slug slithering through my farm. Seriously, no concrete at all. Oh, fucking hell, dude. That is shocking, mate. Look, we've got damage everywhere. Wow, that does surprise me. However, it is time to leave. Let's make sure we're well fed and watered. You're right, XR. I'm just going to go and park myself over here. I'll be back in like 30 seconds because it's quite a long journey. So I'm just going to go and have a little toilet break at the services before we set off, all right? I'm just going to crouch, set a waypoint. North of that. So there. I'll be back in 2 seconds, folks. Right, back. Let's go. An extremely wet fart. It did. It did. It was horrible. Ooh, I actually jumped off the bike there. I didn't mean to do that. Clicked the wrong button. Okay, come on. Let's get out of here. I'm kind of looking forward to coming back to Caliper City now with the bikes fully laden with gorgeous concrete. I feel like I let myself down, let alone you guys and girls there. That was terrible. That was really just shocking. It's just because I'm so excited for all like the new changes we're going to be able to introduce. So, even I mean, I tell you what, we're going to have to change the recipe on the razor wire though. That does seem steep, doesn't it? Because it's quite delicate stuff. It's not like it's going to last through a horde or anything. But using the, what was it, scrap cable? I mean, that stuff is not super easy to come by, is it? Might change it to something that you have to mine but also have to forge. What's that? Not going into the farm? Hey, what do you mean not go to the farm? We've done the farm. You're right, Ice Captain. How are you, mate? I've had a disastrous day, dude. I died, like really properly died, like with all my gear that I couldn't get back. Had the backpack destroyed. Oh, it's shocking, dude. Absolutely shocking. We were doing really well as well. We'd actually started production on the Fort Fuck It, and I just let myself down, mate. I got trapped in my own mind, and rather than like systematically trying to fight my way out, I thought I'd bum rush through and pass them, and they just stunned me into zombie corpse, basically. Gutted, mate. Absolutely gutted. Lost my favourite shotgun and everything. Oh, slow down. Bridge. Might actually, once we've got everything back and all the bikes up and running, the forge is running again, I think I might head back into, you know, the little town near the desert and just see if we can find anything to loot. I kind of want me pullover back. How are you doing, Cam Tully? Oh, well, it was horrible ice. It was not only did like it go horribly wrong, but then we did really well by getting back, you know, to Caliper City and getting another bike rebuilt and heading all the way back to the desert to try and fight our way through. When I got there, it was full of bloody bears and screamers and you name it. It was just a disaster, dude. An absolute unmitigated bloody disaster, mate. So yeah, I've lost a lot of really important stuff, not to mention all the bloody stone and things that I'd mined that evening. I mean, all right, yes, that's easily replaceable, but it all adds up, doesn't it? Oh, there was that hole, look. We just skimmed past it, just to the right-hand side. Wow. Yes, I did. UMA stuff. I don't know if you saw the Q&A the week before Fortune. The UMA side of things is really, really important. It's a little bit like the new block system they've got going. The UMA side of things will be absolutely phenomenal for them. Like he was saying, you know, it opens up so many options for creatures. You know, I mean, Madmol was talking about maybe having bears. You know, we've heard about the wolves being tameable and where they go with that. And in fact, there's actually a mod on SDX where you can capture a dog and train it and breed them and get yourselves like a loyal pet already. So I mean, the modders are already doing that kind of thing. And I'm sure the fun pimps will come up with something a little bit more to their liking as such. But Madmol was talking about bears, wasn't he, and being able to actually tame a bear and put backpacks on it, so it was almost like a carrier. I mean, can you imagine traipsing across the landscape like we are now with a bear in tow? It's saddlebags laden with stone. It just sounds mad, doesn't it? It just sounds like crazy. Do you think they're going to do what Ark did and just become this gotta catch 'em all game? Don't do it, Madmol. Don't do it. Wolves and bears, yes. He sounded very excited for horses, didn't he? I think Madmol secretly would very much like horses in the game, which would be kind of cool. Yeah, I've still got to watch the Q&A, yesterday's Q&A, or at least this week's Q&A. I actually listened to all 43 plus minutes of last week's yesterday afternoon, actually, while I was tinkering with SDX. Yeah, I think the horses, you know, It was interesting listening to Mad Mole. You know, so sometimes like someone will ask, you know, are you going to implement this? Are you going to implement that? And you can sort of really see how, on the face of it, it sounds like, well, yeah, that sounds like a really good idea. But, you know, as an actual developer and someone who's actually got to sit there and work with a team that codes it and everything into the game, you can sort of see just how complicated other things can become. I really liked his absolute honesty around the bandits as well. I think people are going to get a real shock when Alpha 15 first hits. It's like he said, you know, a lot of the Q&A stuff was around, you know, are they going to work in groups? Are they going to try and flank you? And it pretty much in his own words, I mean, please correct me if I'm wrong, but what he said was like, look, the first iteration of this, essentially what we've done is we've created zombies that walk at a different pace and that have guns. You don't start thinking these guys are going to be like wandering across the wilderness and of an evening running into the nearest house and setting up a camp and all that kind of stuff. You know, that's not where we are right now. You know, maybe in months to come, that'll be the kind of stuff and the complexity of AI we're going to be looking at. But right now, what you're going to be getting is reskinned zombies with a bit of a different AI, in the sense that they'll have guns and be able to shoot you, and, you know, obviously won't go all crazy of an evening. I think people are expecting maybe a little bit too much, you know, for the very first Alpha 15 release. Right, let's have a look what sort of a shitstorm we're walking into here, guys. Let's take this really careful. I can see the other mini bike, so that looks intact. That has taken... We really need to sort this out because it's taken such a pounding. It's actually... I nearly died trying to jump out of it, didn't I? It looks a lot quieter. I don't think we've lost too much. There's the black puff of smoke. Okay, we're home. God damn it. Why was it so much easier this time? In fact, can I actually get... Oh, hang on. Let's get the other mini bike parked on that as well. You can't own multiple mini bikes, right? If I lock them all, it's not going to suddenly go, hang on a minute, what's going on, dude? Yeah, I'm looking forward. I'll watch that later. In fact, I might sit out in the garden later this evening and listen to that when the sun's down. It's quite hard to see things on my tablet out there at the minute. Super bright. Sounds like a nice evening there, actually, mate. Okay, we made it back. Let's put the light on. Let's go. I mean, we did bring a load of stuff on the mini bike, didn't we? Got all this water. Well, I'll tell you what, let's just leave it on there. We don't need it. Oh, look, there's the other Magnum rounds. God damn it. Son of a bitch. frames. Wood frames. I'm going to make myself another 30 of those. Oh, whoa. So let's make 25. Yeah, this is where they all got stuck pounding away, look. My corpse must have been just around here, look. So they've obviously had to smash their way through it. So that disappeared. Oh, we lost so much, guys. We really did. We lost so much. But we're back. Bigger, badder than ever. Although my wellness is speaking differently. Definitely going to redo this cave. It's really messed me up. I think a lot of the problem was that not only was I stuck, but I actually had to be out. You know, I needed to be able to jump to get out, and there was just no way. You know, with the best will in the world, I completely boffed that. There's no other way to put it, really. My own stupid, overconfident self cost us quite a lot there. But we'll be all right. We'll be all right. We will survive. I suppose I could actually... In fact, what we'll do is we'll put a ramp in here. We'll We'll put some curved frames in there. Doesn't hurt, does it? Make it like a proper way out. Let's look at how we died and try and resolve that issue. Can't get up. It's a real shame we lost the corpse, because we did so well to get back, didn't we? I mean, we really did race back so quickly. And, well, you know, it was still there, and but just that last few seconds. As soon as I saw that bear, I thought, that's it. We're screwed, mate. There was just no hope as soon as that appeared, was there? That was it, really. Love this stuff. So nice. I'd love this as the walls in some of the tunnels back at Grumbutty Junction. It's going to be tricky, isn't it? Now we're in, let's go and get the forges running and we can play about with this a little bit then, can't we? At least we've got a way in now. Just build like the half amps in there. You right, Elise, how you doing? Oh, I love this game, mate. I've just had quite a catastrophic death, actually, mate. And you know what? It's made me realise how much more... I almost see it as a challenge now, mate. It's a lovely feeling, actually. It's kind of strange. I feel like I've now got something to prove to myself. Let's get both of these up and running again. Let's get that stone boiling up. That's looking nice. Now, I think, to be honest, I'm going to take these out. I think we've got enough for the rebar, so let's convert the full system to... cement production, which is primarily why we're here, so... I just dropped a load of stone in there. Clay can go back, iron can go back, stone can go back. That's where I haven't actually got that much iron. Okay. Let's make ourselves some wooden frames. Probably, what you think, 30? The trees are growing, look. So that's good. Might do a bit of a run over. I think today what I'm going to do is just get this all set up. We've got the rebar. We've got some cement cooking. Let's just get our mine all back to how we want it. I'm a bit mad, actually, because if the razor wire wasn't so expensive, what I'd actually do is put like a few rows of it around the entrance to the mine here. That'd be quite interesting. You know, it's our first modded... if you like, placeable block. It'd be quite nice to see. So put it into practice, wouldn't it? Not sure how we're going to go down from here. It's a bit of a weird spot in it. Everything's going to be at an angle. Why don't we see what we'll do? We'll just backfill it. I need some stone. Well, I'll tell you what, let's go and carve some out. How are you anyway, Inelise? How's things been with you, mate? Did I lose the auger? Oh, God, no. We didn't lose anything that we didn't have that was readily replaceable, apart from my pullover, to be honest, Fortune. But sentimental value for a lot of it. I love my shotgun. I love my hunting rifle. You know, it's not quite the same. The auger is in the gun safe in Bunker Bob, I think, mate. I'm sure we shoved it down in there. Dead by Daylight. It's quite interesting you say that, because I very nearly bought the multi version of that, you know, where you get like three or four copies. And I was going to do like a Friday evenings Grum versus mods and see if Simpson and Fortune wanted to join me. I know Elagon was quite interested in the game as well. I just watched quite a lot of it, mate, and it just started feeling really sort of repetitive. But I'm hoping, given time, that they'll really flesh it out. Does look like a good game, but not for long. You know what I mean? It's one of those things that I think once you've seen it, you've sort of seen it as it currently stands. I'm sure, given another 6 months, they'll maybe the pennies are coming in from the alpha, the beta, whatever the hell it is. We'll start seeing a long-term goal on it. Is an iron reinforced club good? I never use melee weapons, mate. I'm sure they're absolutely brilliant. I'm sure if you fully reinforce one, and you can probably upgrade it to the sledgehammer or get the machete. We've got a katana now, so. Alright, let's make ourselves. Oh, what do you reckon? Let's just make 30. Let's go and get that tunnel done. I don't want to be dying from having to jump everywhere again. And we are spending a lot of evenings in here, so. There's no doubt we're going to get caught with our short and curlies out at some point again. I think, isn't this actually where I died? I think it was, wasn't it? In fact, I'm actually bloody positive it was. So we can get up there. But then you're screwed. Can't think of a way to do this. It's too steep, isn't it? Bloody hell, really? Yeah, bloody bastard. So that's all fine all the way down there, isn't it? How can I smooth this out? There's got to be a way to do it. If we put a ramp in there, that should be about right, shouldn't it? Feels a bit weird, but maybe carve this out just a touch. Weird, it just doesn't feel quite right, but I've not got enough wood to backfill it. What can we put up to protect it from Z's? Oh, Jesus. They've made a right old mess of it, haven't they? What's up? But the Spike Club is the real winner, is it? I don't think I've actually used one. I did enjoy the sledgehammer. The sledgehammer seems to be like a really nice weapon, but it was just so slow. And of course, I made the mistake of trying to hit one of the crawlers with it. And of course, he basically broke my legs. But I wasn't too impressed with that, mate. Okay, that's the entrance done. See what we could do. Let's just sort of like put a row of blocks around it. I'm sure I can put some spikes or something just to try and slow the buggers down, maybe. It's not going to be anything fancy. It's just, they literally just like, because it's sand, they just waltzed through it, didn't they? That'll do us. That'll do us. I mean, I suppose I could even top it off with concrete if we really wanted to. I might go and get some wood. Quite a nice little entrance, actually. Maybe put up. I think we've got. No, we haven't actually. Oh, it's got a smash. That's why we did have, didn't we? We did have a like a little tower of torches. I'm sure we did. That'll do. I'm quite happy with that. So that'll be the way in. Be able to come all the way down here, nice and quick. Not happy with that corner, but it doesn't really matter. Put the brakes on when you get here. And once you're down here, you should... Oh, what? Really? You should be able to give them all a bit of a slap. Which is what I should have done, but I didn't, because I'm a dick. God damn it. Right. I'm happy we're back where we were. The forges are running. Let's go and get ourselves some wood to sort of backfill this. Next horde's 378, right? Are we even going to be on at 378? I'm not sure. This bit's still not right. Backfill.
Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me.
How you doing, Jan? Oh god, that's close. It's just not good, is it? That's just not good. It's freaking me out now. God damn it. We were like one block out all the way, weren't we? I tell you what, can't reach. We're gonna spend a lot of time down here, so I want it right. Fuck. I always need to really? You're not killing me. I'm not quite out. Oh! How's things, Jan? How are you doing, mate? I've had a disastrous day on here, Jan. Disastrous, mate. It's truly been a bad one. Everything that could have gone wrong, it went wrong, dude. It really did. The only way for me to do this is to backfill, to tunnel out all of this all the way back up to that first platform, isn't it? Jesus, I suppose we need the stone. It's not going to, it's not a bad thing. What a pain in the pooper. I was quite proud when we first built this as well, because I actually thought we'd done a really good job of like keeping it easy in and out of. And of course, then we've just found out how terribly dangerous it actually is. You cannot afford to not have a perfectly smooth ramp if you're going to have to jump around. Oh, come on, really? What the hell? What? I call shenanigans right there, sir. I call shenanigans. Weird. Have you just seen it, Sam? Yeah. Yours is awesome, mate. I was quite excited to see what the sky came up with for yours. It is awesome, buddy. You've got, when I put it up later, you'll have to have a look at all the detail in the background, mate. It is absolutely bloody awesome, dude. That's better, isn't it? That's much better. You're right, Gideon. How you doing, mate? I suppose I could do this at night and backfill it in the daytime. We should really go and get the timber. But at the moment, we've got the forges running, so that's all we care about. And then hopefully we'll have enough cement to make the concrete and start for fuck it. We've already two layers up, so... This is what I was actually... I reckon we could have had a full fuck it up and running today if I hadn't died twice. Well, once. Did you like that one then, CM? Part of the big gang now, mate. I'll post it up in the welcome channel in Discord later, dude. Obviously, I don't want to post them up before we do it, because it's kind of cool having it as a surprise, isn't it? Yeah, there's a little cooldown on them. The other thing is, Sam, don't forget, it's also locked to you now, so no one else can actually trigger that. Not even the mods. In theory, not even me, if I use normal chat. I need to find a way, I suppose, for Sim4 to do it if they need to. Oh, actually, I've just thought there is a way to do it, thinking about it. You don't do Discord. How do you survive as a gamer without Discord, mate? I couldn't live without Discord now. It's one of those really weird things. I swore, you know, yeah, whatever, not that interested. And now I just literally, no matter what I do gaming-wise now, I think Discord, is going to have a part to play in that. Is there a reason why you don't do Discord CM? Is it, you know, if you got like a, I don't want to pry if it's something personal, but... Is there a reason why you don't have it? I know we were in chat the other day. A lot of people were talking quite negatively about Discord and about how it had killed certain other means of communication within various games. Didn't quite get the gist of it, but there was definitely an opinion around Discord was the devil for some folks. I must admit, there's still a long way to go with Discord, isn't there, as we found out ourselves on our own Discord server. There's a myriad of things that really could do with being made either simpler or a little bit more flexible for folks that want to run a busy Discord server. You are quite limited to what you can do at the moment, you know, compared to a bog standard forum or something like TeamSpeak. You joined Discord yesterday and got woken up at 6 a.m. this morning by notifications. Yes, I think a pro tip when it comes to Discord, it's the same as WhatsApp, is to turn off the extremely noisy notifications, mate. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, Gideon. That would have been me, mate. That would have been me giving a hello to everybody on the server and discussing what I'd been up to with the SDX mods, mate. I'll take the full blame for that one. Now it's a little bit better. I'm happier with that now. I feel like I've got an actual mind rather than just some horrible mess. There we go. Much better. Just think about putting maybe some crafting stations or something up here in a little bit. Even if it's just like just a campfire as an alternate from the one we've got at the crafting station. It doesn't hurt to have some. I think I'm just getting a bit paranoid now after what happened earlier, to be quite honest with you. I'm also quite enjoying doing the backfilling with the destroyed stone. It's a nice material, this. Oh, no, not going to make that, am I? Jesus, nowhere near, dude. How far down is that? That should look quite nice. I don't think that's too far. There we go. Yeah, that's much better. I'm pretty chuffed with that, actually. So it doesn't serve any particularly super duper important. God damn it, really. Oh, fucking hell, dude. It's like literally as I click it, it suddenly flashes to that alternate block. There, look. Stay. There we go. Bish, bash, bosh, mate. Job's a good end. Right, perfect. So we've now got, hopefully, what amounts to a smooth ramp all the way out. Do you reckon I can make a quick run to get the wood? Or is that risking it a bit? So I just suddenly realised I'm sitting about 6 feet away from the microphone. I've been really leaning back there. Grub died because he got cocky. I am not going to argue with that. That's exactly what happened. That is exactly what happened. I'm about to get even cockier, Simpsy, because we're about to go and chop some wood. And I don't have any torches to light the way home. Let's not do it. Let's not do it. Should we stay here and do spins for hours and hours and hours? I've just saw a Z over there. Charcoal will take. Stone can all go back in there. Torches. Let's make 4 torches. Throw them down. Let's go and kill this Z who's decided to come and say hello to me. I'll tell you what we do need to do is actually go looking for feathers, isn't it? We are actually out of feathers. I had like a stockpile of about 750 at one point. That's a fucking screamer. What's that noise? What's that? What is that noise? Oh my god! Oh my god, dude! Oh my god, dude! Oh god, please don't make me die. I don't want to die again. I really don't want to die again. Oh, Jesus, what is with this place, guys? Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God, that fucking bear's back, dude! I actually feel really, really, really vulnerable out here for the first time. Honestly, for the first time in weeks. Oh, what the hell? On this game, what's happened? why is the desert known to be a nightmare or something? You think it'd be, you know, why would there be loads of Z's wandering around in the goddamn desert? You don't get loads of people wandering around in the goddamn desert there. What are you all doing out here? Oh God, really? Oh, God, really? Shoot him in the goddamn leg. Oh, my God. I cannot afford to keep missing arrows like this, dudes. Oh, God, what's that noise? Oh, fuck me. Oh, God, that is fucking it. Screw you. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Absolutely freaking unbelievable. Dude, really? You know what, I swear I can hear Daphne. I'm trying to clear the area before we go down. Oh my God! I just heard another one. I've just heard another scream. I swear to God, this place is freaking cursed. Oh my God, dude, really? Shit, that was a bad shot, mate. That was a bad shot. I really don't like the desert anymore. This was a shit idea, setting up a concrete production plant in the middle of a goddamn desert. I don't know who the fuck thought of that, but it was dumb. Oh God, there's another screamer! It's worse than bloody Honey Scrow Orchard, guys! What is going on? There's a feral... Why is this happening? Oh, come on, that was right up your nostril, dude. 9:39. Oh my God. Really? A nasty moldy sandwich. I'm not getting stuck in that goddamn mine again, I swear. Oh my Lord, this is shocking. Right, I think I'm gonna go, oh, what? You know what, I should have brought calipers, mate. We are gonna be so low on ammo if this keeps happening every night. Right, that's it. I can't risk it. I've got to go. If there's anything else out there, that's it. Game over, mate. Shit, food. Ooh. Oh. This is a whole new